Happy Ever After is our newest spectacular at Magic Kingdom. This show takes our audience on an incredible journey in search of Happy Ever After. The show is supported by a beautiful musical score that we just recorded in London.
Overall, really good. We're just going to need to tighten up a little bit rhythmically.
Happily Ever After takes the listener on a musical journey.
The story of friendship, the story of perseverance, of overcoming obstacles, and then ultimately victory. It was fantastic to arrange this and come together here with the orchestra.
I think what's been best about this project is just this collaborative process we've had in working with the team that's doing the visuals. It's been inspiring. The stuff they're doing on the castle is something I've never seen before. That's been an inspiring thing in terms of the music.
Right now, animators are finishing up the drawings that will be placed upon the castle, bringing our characters to life in a new and exciting way.
It's just fun to play with these characters in a completely different context than the original film, but certainly harken back to the original film.
And our pyrotechnics team is designing a show that will light up the sky like it's never been seen before.
I think the emotions for me is all those things that you felt the first time you came to Magic Kingdom. You know, the wonder and the excitement, sometimes a little scary, but ultimately just a profound sense of magic. There's really no other way to put it, and this is a magical show.
The show is gonna blow everyone away. We cannot wait to share this with our audiences later this year.
Happily Ever After is an exciting new nighttime spectacular that is designed for Walt Disney World's Magic Kingdom. It is an experience unlike any other, and it brings together kind of a wonderful kiss goodnight for our guests, a way to celebrate all the different characters and the experiences that they've seen in the park throughout the day with fireworks and lasers, lighting, and an incredible new score. The show really follows the hero's journey, and it kind of takes us on all of those different milestones that we experience, from a dream to going on the journey, to meeting friends, to falling in love, to facing adversity and overcoming challenge, and hopefully to triumph and to finding our own happily ever after.
Because what's so exciting is what you were talking about, right, of the tentacles physically wrapping around. I'm really excited about this project. I think it's going to be one of the most spectacular things at Walt Disney World, and we really want this show to have all of the heart and the majesty that Wish has had, to be able to experience all new songs, and to do it with new technology, to use projection, to incorporate lasers, to have new lighting, and to be able to paint with fireworks in the sky. As much as you love Wishes, definitely hang on, because we do take the great things, we make them even better, and we're really excited about this project.
The visuals that we're seeing on the castle that our design team is working on is truly magical. You know, it's really important to come out here and take a look at our visuals that we've been talking about and seeing it actually displayed upon the castle. We get to check to see if the storytelling is really working for us and make it come to life.
Growing up as a kid, seeing the castle in Disney and being able to kind of work off of that as the canvas to start from. You know, it's not just paper, it's not just a cell, it's the physical structure of this castle as our starting point, is a really powerful medium to be using.
I think it works though.
It does, totally. Yeah.
Happily Ever After is unlike any castle show you have ever seen.
When we started this project, we wanted to challenge ourselves to find a way to make Happily Ever After unique, to approach projection mapping in a way that has never been done before. And I think we've done that. I think we have looked for opportunities to really push the boundaries of what the surface can contain and how, what it can become.
Most of these moments where you see somebody shoot something ties to a laser then ties to a firework.
We have so tightly worked with the other disciplines to integrate all the technologies together. It's not just projection, it's not just lights, it's not just fireworks. We're working day to day with one another as we develop our content so that there's an integration between what the fireworks are doing and what the castle is doing. So that as the audience experiences the show, there's a cohesiveness. In that way, I think that we're able to push the boundaries that have never been pushed before.
It's been remarkable to see all of these different elements that are working simultaneously, but really coming together and creating something that is so special. True collaboration is really the magic of the show. Happily Ever After is really synonymous with so many of those amazing Disney films that we love, and it's a great way to kind of celebrate the journey that a lot of our characters take. One of the best parts of the project has been working with some of the original artists from feature animation and seeing them create animations just for this show that are going to live on the castle.
There's some ideas that they wanted to have in the story that didn't exist in the films, and so they asked us to come on and animate some new animation of these characters.
As artists, you're always kicking yourself or saying, gee, I wished I could go back and do something or make a change, and so they actually have the chance to go back and revisit a character.
It's super exciting. I mean, for me, it's a thrill because Aladdin was the first film I worked on, and to come back and be animating Aladdin again after 25 years and feeling that same kind of excitement and thrill I did when I first got here, you know, this is a dream come true to be a Disney animator, you know.
It's just fun to play with these characters in a completely different context than the original film, but certainly harken back to the original film. One thing that I wanted to do in this sequence was at Ursula's most dramatic moment in the original film, she's underlit. So we're gonna go for that same kind of underlit look on her, so she's highly dramatic as she rises up and her tentacles wind around the various castle turrets.
And then I think that these characters, the stories and the journeys that they've all gone through that we see in the show, will remind people that, you know, Happily Ever After still can exist. We can still have our hopes and dreams and still hope for that Happily Ever After.